Hi, welcome back to my channel. I'm Auntie Isley, and today I am reviewing This Is Me Now by J-Lo. The movie was incredible. It was a visual album type of movie, and it was just filled with lover girl energy. And I love lover girl energy. When she mentioned that when someone asked her what she wanted to be when she grew up, she said she wants to be in love. And her actions in her lifetime kind of show that that's how she moves. And a person who is a hopeless romantic, I can totally relate to that. So I really loved it. I loved just her dancing, her performance, her acting, everything about, oh, and it was visually incredible. It was directed by the great Dave Myers. I've worked with him before, so, you know, he's always been super talented. And those two have worked together multiple times, too, on video. So this was a very good collaboration between them, a great fire collaboration between the two. So happy for Dave, and really excited for J-Lo, because this is her own Lemonade, if you guys remember Beyonce's Lemonade. It reminds me of that. But this was a little more visually stimulating. I mean, it was just like the landscapes and the everything that was happening. It was just, you couldn't take your eyes off the screen, just sort of like Lemonade. But this I, oh my god, this was incredible. I loved the cameos she had. She had Fat Joe as the psychologist, her therapist, which was so funny, but it was such a great idea. And I think that they kind of know each other from Jenny from the Block. You know, they know each other from the hood. So I think just to see where both of them have come in their careers is beautiful. But yeah, Ben Affleck, her love, he made an appearance as another character. And Jennifer Lewis, as I was saying before, she was part of the spirit guides and astrology guides. She was the Gemini, and I love that. It was two Jennifer Lewis's. And Kiki Palmer, Jay Shetty, Sophia Vergara, Trevor Noah. I mean, they were all their own zodiac signs. So it was so funny, but it was just so just enjoyable. It was a musical of beauty and of love and adventure and of pain, deep pain, because it went through, you know, the ups and downs of love. I mean, there was like one love that was abusive, verbally and physically, that she took us through, which was, oh, I love that scene. I love that. That was my favorite scene, because most of us, if you've lived long enough, you've had like, you know, those type of, you know, weird men like that. So she showed us that she got past that, and then she married again, and she married again, and it was just lover girl energy. And I'm not mad at that, because she got her happily ever after. I mean, we're praying it's her happily ever after, but have you seen the way Ben looks at J-Lo? Have you seen the way J-Lo looks at Ben? Yeah, Spinning the Block was the best thing those two could have did. I don't really think that neither one of them were happy with their other partners. I think that they just, it was right person, wrong time. And now the timing is right, and they have a blended family, and now they're happily, passionately in love. Lover girl energy. Ooh, it's nothing better than that. We need more of that. We need more softness. We need more people who don't settle. That's what it was about. It's about never settling. And I love that. I live by that. So to see her show how she kept going, if she wasn't happy, she moved on. There's nothing in the world wrong with that. And that's what this movie was about, finding true love. And she did that with Ben. And this album, this visual album movie, was nothing short of amazing. Thank you, J-Lo, for this piece of art. We love you. I would say definitely a must-see. Check it out. It's on Prime. I think it came out a few days ago. Check it out. You're going to love it. If you're a lover girl, or if you're a hopeless romantic, you will love it. All right.